speaking of dumplings, this is the part we're all waiting for. As the ultimate dumpling master, what are the biggest mistakes people make when it comes to making dumplings?
Biggest mistakes. Okay. Well, if they're making the dough from scratch, I would say people's biggest mistakes are just not being patient, not resting it to let the gluten kind of relax, not covering it with maybe a damp tea towel just so that it doesn't dry out, because the worst thing that you encounter with wrapper is that it dries out and kind of cracks and breaks. In terms of fillings, I think people usually are pretty good with that. Like, you can really fill a dumpling with anything.
Yeah.
But what I've found is a lot of people will overfill a dumpling, and that's when you kind of really struggle to put it together there. And then it's a bit of a nightmare if you overfill it. So I would say for people at home to underfill it and kind of work from there and see and find a good point. But other than that, I think, a lot of people at home have done a great job at making dumplings.
The wrapper is tricky for first timers.
Definitely. The stickiness, and it just gets everywhere and it frustrates you, and then you end up going to the supermarket and buying a pack of pre-made wrappers.
But they're not the same, is it? No. Buying the pre-made versus actually kneading the dough by hand, it's definitely not the same experience.
There's a bite to it.
Yeah.
To a homemade 100%. One.
It does depend on like the texture that you're going for. Like, I like a bit of a chewy kind of consistency, but I'm not against store-bought wrappers at all.
Oh, okay. Well, you heard it here from Brendan. Not against store-bought wrappers.
I got to admit, I'm a store-bought wrapper girl.
And so many of the things that you just said in terms of the biggest mistakes, it actually reminds me a lot of making dumplings with my grandma and sort of seeing how she does it. Those things that you said, that is exactly how she does it. Wet tea towel, let the gluten sit, and do not overfill it. Those are literally the best tips that you could give.
Okay, so back to your famous rainbow colored dumplings that we cannot get over. What is your secret? How do you put the color in the dumplings so perfectly?
Yeah, good question. I actually haven't made them in a while. But I would say a base kind of dumpling wrapper recipe is 2 parts flour to 1 part water and a bit of salt. So, for example, if you've got 400 grams of flour, you go about 200 grams of water. And for me, just to add color in, you can add it into that water first, or like the liquid. So, and if you're being really kind of health conscious, which when I made them, I don't really like to use preserved kind of colorings and stuff. So I use things like beetroot juice, or like I'll dissolve some turmeric or something into that water. And that's where I kind of color the dough. And then you just go from there. You just kind of be really playful with it. You can mix different colored doughs together. Yeah, it's just really up to you.
Yeah. For our listeners who have not seen these beautiful rainbow colored dumplings, we're going to leave a direct link in the show notes. You can go to Brendan's Instagram. We've seen you make a Christmas tree inspired one.
Roses.
Where did you sort of get these ideas from? Do they just sort of pop into your head? Do you get inspiration?
It's just really having a bit of fun and kind of playing with the shapes and the dough. I guess you can make anything really. Like, I've seen people make goldfish, what else, like flowers. It depends on how patient you are, really.
My grandma has a type of dumpling that looks like a little mouse, and we call it the little mouse design, and we would like make 100
cute.
Little mouse.
If you could choose only 10 ingredients to make the perfect dumplings, maybe to win MasterChef, what would they be?
10 ingredients. Let me count. Is this just the filling, or is this the wrapper as well? I could probably put the wrapper in there.
Yeah.
10 ingredients. I go flour and water for the pastry. Then I've got like a fatty pork mince, perhaps some fresh prawns from here in Perth, which in like Exmouth, which would be really tasty. Yeah, that's 4 ingredients. For seasoning, I'd go oyster sauce, a bit of light soy, a bit of Shaoxing cooking wine, a bit of sesame oil, white pepper.
Yeah.
And I would either go in with a bit of ginger or spring onion. Yeah. I think that would be great. Yeah, just that there, a simple pork and prawn dumpling.
Wow, very flavorful. 100%. Yeah. You've got all the Asian flavor. The sesame oil, that's very important.
The white pepper.
Yes.
The white pepper. Yeah.